Hello, I am Mr. Beeman. I am the TRT at Craddock Elementary School. As we grow as a nation, it is important to honor those who have come before us and those who are paving new pathways as we speak. In light of this, here at Craddock Elementary School, we are celebrating National Hispanic Heritage Month. It is an opportunity for us to recognize and appreciate the rich cultural contributions of Hispanic individuals in our society. Feliz de la Herencia Hispania. Happy Hispanic Heritage Month.
Good evening. I am excited to announce that we have designated October 11th in order to celebrate Hispanic Heritage Month here at Craddock Elementary School. This is an opportunity to honor the unique voices and experiences of Hispanic and Latino Americans in order to recognize the histories, journeys, and achievements. Here are a few fun facts. President Lyndon B. Johnson officially created Hispanic Heritage Week on September 17, 1968. The idea, as Johnson explained it, was to honor the impact that people of Hispanic descent have had in the United States.
In 1988, when President Reagan was in office, Hispanic Heritage Week was expanded from a week to a month.
Hispanic Heritage Month starts on September 15th each year because El Salvador, Honduras, Costa Rica, Guatemala, and Nicaragua all observe their Independence Day on that date. Mexico's is September 16th. And Chile, September 18th, also celebrate their Independence Day during Hispanic Heritage Month.
More than 62 million people in the United States identifies as Hispanic.
In the United States, Mexican Americans make up the largest Hispanic population.
Feliz mes de Heritage Hispana.
We believe that through these celebrations, we can inspire younger generations and bring our community together. Thank you for your support and encouragement in making this event a success.
Hello, my name is Rita Wilson, and I am the Parent and Family Engagement Liaison at Craddock Elementary School. Today, I will be sharing some facts about Hispanic heritage. Latinas and Latinos have been game changers in the United States sports industry. Many athletes are representing the Latino community as trailblazers within their sports, such as a professional golfer, Lizette Salas, and former professional soccer player and National Soccer Hall of Fame member, Marcelo Balboa. Fun facts. Over the years, the Latino community has helped to shape America's favorite pastime, baseball. As of opening day in 2023, about 30% of Major League Baseball players are Hispanic or Latino. Latinas have also shaped baseball history, serving as players, broadcasters, and team owners. In the 1990s, Linda Alvarado purchased the Colorado Rockies and made history as the first woman to ever win a bid to buy a team. This purchase also resulted in her becoming the first Hispanic MLB team owner. These contributions, amongst others, have forever transformed the game of baseball and continue to impact the world of sports. Happy Hispanic Heritage Month!
Hi, I'm Mr. Loth, the assistant principal at Craddock Elementary, and happy Hispanic Heritage Month. Iconic Latino food dishes featuring diverse ingredients and cooking techniques have influenced the United States food culture for many years. With a blend of core ingredients like corn, meat, beans, and rice, traditional Latino cuisine is prominently featured alongside mainstream dishes. Latino food has always had a presence in the U.S. and is responsible for many cultural favorites, like Tex-Mex style restaurants. These restaurants first gained their popularity in the 1800s with entrepreneurs, chefs, restaurant owners like Adelaida Cuellar migrating to the United States. Some examples of Latino foods include pozole, which is often made during the holiday season and is a Mexican soup with hominy meat and broth. Mofongo is a classic dish from Puerto Rico and is popular in many countries. Mofongo is made from fried green plantains mashed together with other ingredients like garlic and crackling pork rinds. Tamales is a dish made of mesa wrapped in corn husk or banana leaves. Common fillings would include various meats, beans, and cheese. These culinary influences have continued to shape the culture of our nation. Once again, happy Hispanic Heritage Month.
Mientras celebramos a las comunidades hispanas y latinas más a la de este mes, del 15 de septiembre al 15 de octubre, damos un reconocimiento adicional a las muchas contribuciones hechas a la historia y la cultura de los Estados Unidos, incluido el importante trabajo de promoción, los deportes, el arte vibrante y las comidas populares y tradicionales y mucho más. While we celebrate Hispanic and Latino communities beyond this month, from September 15th to October 15th, we give extra recognition to the many contributions made to the history and culture of the United States, including important advocacy work, sports, vibrant art, popular and traditional foods, and much more. Happy Hispanic Heritage Month. Feliz Mes de la Herencia Hispana.
Buenas tardes, me llamo Toria Sanchez. I am the art teacher here at Craddock Elementary School, here to tell you some fun facts about Hispanic Heritage Month. The experiences of the Latino community has been seen throughout the American entertainment industry, from sharing styles of dance to being leaders in sports. Latinos and Latinas continue to bring their unique experiences and perspectives as they provide strong contributions to our society. With music styles like salsa, merengue, and reggaeton, Latinas and Latinas continue contributing to the music and dance industries in the United States. Many forms of music and dance have been spread throughout the United States and the influences of Latinos and Latinas. Puerto Rican, Mexican-American dancer and choreographer Tina Ramirez founded Ballet Hispanico in 1970 to celebrate Latino communities through dance. Ramirez later went on to become a National Medal of Arts recipient. Another Medal of National Media of Arts recipient, Celia Cruz, helped to popularize salsa dance music in the United States by embracing her heritage. Salsa music across New York in the 1960s and the 1970s blended Cuban and Afro-Latino and Afro-Latin musical traditions. Cruz, known as the Queen of Salsa, broke boundaries as one of the few women to succeed in the world of salsa music and celebrated her Afro-Latino culture by popularizing in Spanish during the U.S. Civil Rights Movement. Feliz de la Herencia Hispana!